following is brought to you by Cranbrook Television Limited.
Welcome to Round Town.
1978 Sam Steele Day is great.
1980 is a period.
Welcome to Rocky Arctic.
This is my guest, Roy Orbison.
To call on Mr. Brian Tully, the President of the Chamber of Commerce, for his farewell address. Brian?
Wayne, turn this sucker on. I don't need this, do I? Kieran and I met about 2 weeks ago and said, do you want to make a farewell address, take 17 minutes and talk about a lake at the end of Baker Street? She said no, but you can have 25 minutes. And then she rephrased it and said, I'll write the speech, you make the comments, it'll take a minute and 30 seconds to cover the accomplishments for the last year. So we edited it all down, we have it on 11 pages here, and we re-edited it, and I'd like to say a couple of things. Quickly, it's not my purpose to look back, because Cranbrook's a forward-looking community, and I think we want to continue to look forward, but I would like to start by saying thank you very much to two people, to Karen Penner and to Laura Clorac. I get the publicity, I get the newspaper, I get the pictures, I get the glory, and they do the work. So Karen and Laura, thank you very much. And Gary, you'll have to shrink in order to get in the same shoes, okay? As your chamber president this past year, I want to take the opportunity to congratulate our chamber membership and our community at large for its investment in our great city. The investment has been made by many and in many forms. The early spring cleanup campaign, the tremendous success of our second job entry training program, the outstanding support for the Man in Motion campaign, the activities that are taking place as a result of the sister city relationship with Coeur d'Alene, and an excellent working relationship with the city of Cranbrook. As much as Randy and I argue, he's not a half a bad guy. Okay. Randy, that's as good as I can get, I'm sorry. The Olympic torch is coming through Cranbrook on Tuesday. We have fantastic cooperation from and participation from teachers, students, citizens, corporations. Nobody has said no. The list continues. You walk up and say, would you mind? They say, how much do you want? What do you want us to do? There's never any question. They always do it. It's phenomenal. That demonstrates a community of work, at work. A community that cares and a community that is willing to risk itself for others. Yes, we do live in an exciting community and much is happening. Your Chamber of Commerce is growing and working hard to provide you as members or prospective members of the Chamber with information and services that will impact on your business and our community. Something really important, we've managed to put together a tremendously active Superhost training program this year. And remember how important that is to Cranbrook, that your staff is trained to deal with the public. We've got lots of dates, we're going to do lots of work, so please call. We can train your staff, improve your business, and raise our profile. This year, for the first time, your chamber is introducing an annual report and a membership roster, so you'll know who's part of the chamber. We give out referral slips to our visitors and refer them to chamber members. And we do that deliberately because chamber members care and they get the referrals. We reflect back and look ahead, and we see a chamber and a community on the move. It's happening because of the investment by many with their time, their energy, and their talents. The returns are great because of you. Our board of directors would publicly like to thank some individuals for their investment in the Cranbrook Chamber of Commerce and present them with certificates of appreciation. In recognition of 15 years of service to the board of directors of the Cranbrook Chamber of Commerce, Jackie Van Gene, we thank you for your outstanding commitment. Please, Jackie. I had to keep her away from the microphone. She's always talking about women's lip. The chamber depends greatly on volunteers to assist us with many of our projects. They talk and they walk and they work. From floats to meetings, decorations to host couples. I'd like to ask Sharon and Bruce Coventry to come up here and receive their acknowledgement as volunteers for our great city. Some thanks at this point very quickly. I want to thank you, Rosemary, very understanding wife, a great board of directors, and thanks again to the chamber membership, the ones that are involved and committed to this great community. And thank you, community, for your vision. Thank you very much. I made a couple of comments about incoming presidency and whatnot, and I laid a gavel somewhere on the table, and somebody in the room saw fit to remove it. However, it was returned to me, and I'd like to pass it on to Gary now and make sure he doesn't lose it. Unfortunately, it shrunk a little bit, and I would like, just Gary, put it in your pocket. That way they can't get it.
I'd now like to call on Gary Knight and Mayor Rick Jenson for the swearing-in ceremony and other things.
Good evening. When Brian was talking with Karen this afternoon, and she said that he was going to be short. I thought she was mentioning his height. Good speech, Brian. Gary, could you come up, please? This is something that we've never done before. We've sworn in some president of chambers of commerce, but we haven't presented them with a gift before. And Gary, being the bright young lad that he is, we thought it appropriate that we present him with a gift this evening.
Tim, this isn't from you, is it? Oh,
Brian, this one I'll put in my pocket.
It's indeed a privilege tonight to swear in the president of the Cranbrook Chamber of Commerce. Gary, your oath of office, I would like to read it out and you affirm it at the end. Gary Knight, do you affirm that you will faithfully and truly perform your duties as president of the Cranbrook Chamber of Commerce, and that you will, in all matters connected with the discharge of such duty, do all things and such things only as you shall truly and conscientiously believe to be adapted to promote the objects for which the Cranbrook Chamber of Commerce was constituted, according to the true intent and meaning of the same. So help you God.
I do.
Congratulations.
Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to welcome you personally to the Cranbrook Chamber of Commerce Annual General Meeting and the Citizen of the Year Award, sometimes known as the Bud and Maxine Caldwell Roast. Who's the short guy that was up here?
The mayor.
This speech I actually had ready last year at this time, and for some unknown reason I wasn't able to give it. And every time I mentioned to Brian, why? All he would say, well, Gorbachev's in for life, why aren't I? I am greatly honored to fill the position of the president of the Cranbrook Chamber of Commerce for the coming year. It's going to be a very interesting year. Lots of things are going to happen. We've been talking with the mayor, and he is just 100% positive, and the board of directors and myself of the chamber are exactly the same. We've had an excellent year in 87. We're going to have an excellent year in 88. We've attained some of our goals in 87. We had a brainstorming session last weekend where we laid out additional goals, more objectives for 1988, and there's lots to do. To keep you informed as to what we are doing, we have started a series of half-hour television programs, one of which you are part of right now. They're going to be aired on cable 11, two of which have been done already, if you haven't seen them. We are going to increase our use of the Community Focus program on the EK radio. And of course, there's always our chamber newsletter to be read, which is full of vital information. My first official act as president of the Cranbrook Chamber of Commerce, I would like to introduce to you a group of people that are really going to make things happen in 1988 for Cranbrook. If I could ask these individuals to stand and remain standing, and if you would hold your appreciation until they're all standing, please. From the coach house, our first vice president, Mr. Larry Dees. The Royal Bank, second vice president, Dave Chong. From Caldwell Agencies, our past president, Mr. Brian Tully. From Dunwoody and Company, our treasurer, Mr. Ron Olenek. From Canadian Airlines, our ambassador, Mr. Pat Massaw. From the City of Cranbrook, this short fellow right here, City Manager Appointee, Mr. Tim Wood. Our counselor, Mr. Morris McNair. From EK Radio, Director at Large, Ray Wilson. From the Inn of the South, Director at Large, Bill Collins. From BC Tel, Membership Director, Barb Liversich. Rocky Mountain Printers, our Tourism Director, Helmut Fisher. From Marcella's, Retails Director, Pat Coles. Canadian Imperial Bank of Commerce, Retails Director, Bill Watt. Crestbrook Forest Industries, Industrial Director, John Dutton. East Kootenai Community College Appointee, our Education Director, Delphine Kennelly. from the Bonanza Restaurant. I got to mention you, Vicki. Representing Sam Steele Society, Vicki Adams. East Kootenai Community College, Jake McGinnis. The Camel Foundation, Gary Anderson. City of Cranbrook, Business Development Officer, Mr. Rand Archibald. Our Chamber Manager, Karen Penner. And our Chamber Assistant Manager, you just got a promotion, Laura. Laura Clorak. Ladies and gentlemen, a group that's going to make things happen in 1988. And I left the best to last, the Senator Ron Tarr. Now I have a very enjoyable task. I've been asked to present an award to Mr. Brian Tully. This award is being presented to Mr. Tully because of his long devoted hours to chamber business, because of his achieving his goals of increasing chamber membership, raising the profile and visibility of the chamber in Cranbrook and in the province, and for the enthusiasm that he brings to the board of directors of the chamber. Mr. Tully is a good leader, he's persistent, he's a doer, and he has a great love for the city of Cranbrook. Did you want to say any words, Brian?
I'm the oldest, so I get to speak first. It's funny because Mom and I get closer in age every year. Now that I'm 30, she was 9 when I was born. We had some telegrams called in today. We'll just start reading them if it's okay. Congratulations, they couldn't have chosen two nicer people. We are thrilled for you. Sorry we can't be there, but our thoughts are with you. Love, Pat and Johnny Baird, Peterborough, Ontario.
Uncle Bud and Aunt Max, our love and best wishes on receiving this award. No one deserves it more. Love, Anne and Brian in Victoria.
That's a long one. Aloha from Hawaii. Congratulations to both of you. Would like to be there, but it was a toss-up between this tropical paradise and Cranbrook in winter. However, we are very proud of that the two of you are receiving this memorable award. We send our love and best wishes, Peg and Peter. P.S. Bud, turn up your hearing aid so you can hear all the nice things they're saying about you.
Mom and Dad, sorry we can't be there, but we'll see you in a few weeks. Congratulations. Love, Mike, Corinne, Brent, and Brian. Lilo at BC.
And Mom and Dad, wish we could be there, but we're opening a branch office of Caldwell Agencies in Mexico. We'll have a margarita tonight in your honor. Love, Harry and Morris. P.S. Please send pesos. There's some people that came from quite a distance for tonight, and we'd just like to mention who they are. Mr. and Mrs. Miller, Mom's friend, Eileen Miller, they just about didn't get here because we got them stuck, or we were stuck getting them. They came from Calgary. And Mr. and Mrs. Leon Kahn came from Vancouver. Stand up. And my mom's aunt, who's going to be 85 here shortly, came from Calgary. Aunt Florence? And Beth and Darcy came from Kingston, Ontario, moved their holidays up so they could be here. I'd like to introduce my mom and dad's families. My dad's brother came from, and his wife, Aunt, Uncle Jack and Aunt Elsie came from Nanaimo. Can you stand up? And my dad's sister, Aunt Helen, and Uncle Henry.
Please stand up.
my dad's other two sisters, Aunt Peg and Aunt Lois, couldn't be here tonight. And my dad's brother, my mom's brother, Uncle Al, Albert Holmes, and Aunt Deanie. And I guess we have to mention Uncle Wes, too. And Gary Stockton came all the way from Fort McLeod. My brothers couldn't be here tonight, and they're feeling quite badly. First of all, they hate to miss a party. And Mike's working in Lillooet, and he couldn't get off. He'll be here in a couple of weeks. And Harry and Loris couldn't change their trip once they found out about the dinner. We're very proud of Mom and Dad, and we know how involved they've been over the years. We've been going afloat since we were 4 years old. Our family's probably a lot like other families. You know, just take it for granted that you love each other. We love you very much.
Liz missed one other person in our family. And I don't like to admit it, but we adopted him about a month ago. Brian.
Our adoptive brother, Brian.
And thank you all for coming in and honoring our parents like this.
I would just like to say that my parents have been very dedicated to the community, as you all know, but they have been even more dedicated to the family.
Nice kids, eh? Shush. That's what happens for me, senior. Yeah. I'd now like to call on Pat and Alan Coles for a Citizen of the Year profile.
Thank you. Pat and I would like to say how proud we are to have been asked to say a few words to tell you what we know about Bud and Maxine. Unfortunately, we can't tell you everything because we have to go on being friends. But we can tell you that the Citizen of the Year Award isn't given out for 1 year's activity. It's an accumulation of service to the community. You don't have to be on the front pages to receive this award. A lot of the good work that goes on in the community is done behind the scenes, quietly. And that's Bud and Maxine. There are some couples that can only be described as giving people, and that's Bud and Maxine. The dictionary defines synergism as an action done jointly where the total effect is greater than if done individually. And that's Bud and Maxine as a team. Let me tell you about Bud Maxine, or Bud Caldwell. He was born in Cranbrook in 1924, getting up there. He was a paratrooper during the Second World War. Actually, Bud tells me that the thing he remembers most about the war was the cold. He tells me that sometimes when they were dropped in behind enemy lines and had to sleep outside overnight, all he had between him and the ground was a thin native woman. One of those people who gets involved in things. He was a kinsman. He's a charter member of the K-40 Club, a Rotarian. He's a past president of the Shrine, although we don't let him in the band. He belongs to the Legion and was active in getting the present building constructed. He gets involved in politics at all levels. Not always successfully.
Can you hear that?
But he's not afraid to stand up and be counted is a big thing. As a realtor, he was a member of the Real Estate Council of British Columbia, past president of the Kootenai Real Estate Board, Bud and Maxine are both honorary life members. As a notary, he could have retired 10 years ago if he had charged everyone a fee when he could have, especially our senior citizens. But those are only statistics. To appreciate Bud, you really have to understand where he's coming from, his code of ethics, how much he cares about people, and his personal motto, which is never hurt anyone. Never hurt anyone. Now, what can I add to that?
Well, actually, I could add something to that. It's not funny yet. Bud is an absolutely wonderful dancer, and his favorite, absolute favorite, is Patti Page singing the Tennessee Waltz.
That's true, that's true.
Now, I thought Patti Page was here this evening.
I did.
Is Patti Page
here this evening? I'm not going to sing, honestly. You know, Maxine, you don't know how thrilled I was to know that I was going to be here this evening with a microphone in front of all these people, these captive people, so that I could tell them about all the bizarre things you've done through the years. However, the chamber told us we could only speak for 4 hours, and I could not begin to touch on that subject in 4 hours. Maxine's involvement in the community started at a very early age in the girls' band when she was a bugler. She went on from then to be become queen of the winter carnival. Now that was something I didn't know about, but we know Maxine is not one to toot her own horn, or perhaps I should say blow her own bugle. In later years, she worked at the health unit I think household finance came in there somehow, and then she became a realtor. She wrote her exam for a real estate agent about 1 week after their last child, Janice, was born, and Maxine told me how wonderful it was to be in the hospital after the delivery. She had all this peace and quiet to study for her exam. It was wonderful. She serves as a director on the Kootenai Real Estate Board for a total of 6 years. 2 years of those were as president. The first woman in BC to be elected as a board president. She went on from there to have another first. She was also the first woman in BC to be elected to the Real Estate Council, where she served two terms on that council. After she retired from there, she obviously had nothing to do. She ran successfully then as an alderman for the city of Cranbrook. It was during her term as alderman that she chaired the Economic Development Commission and brought to its term the economic strategy for Cranbrook. She also organized the homecoming for Cranbrook's Jubilee. You know, I get exhausted just thinking about all these things. As you know, she is now currently chairing the steering committee for the auditorium, and they have just had a very successful launch 2 weeks ago with their gala event. For the past 2 years, Maxine has been the convener for fashion shows for Daughters of the Nile. She was instrumental in raising over $4,000. This money is used to buy artificial limbs for the children in Shrine Hospitals. She is also an enthusiastic member of the Cranbrook Curling Club, especially during bond spills. Pardon me, I should say specifically during bond spills. And Maxine, some of those skits were truly bizarre. Maxine also was the first person to introduce chicken shit bingo into... Ellen, did you put that in there? That is ridiculous.
I made a mistake. What can I say?
But I'm sorry. You know, it's really impossible this evening to start to tell you about all Maxine's character, her attributes. The list is just simply too long. The only thing that I can say very short is that through the years, she has been a wonderful mother. She has been a wonderful member of our community. And as many of you here know tonight, she has been a wonderful friend to us all. The Chamber of Commerce received over 30 letters in support of Bud and Maxine's nominations. And we would just like to share a few lines from just a few of these letters with you this evening.
Don't get nervous.
Tell her to quit laughing.
Citizen of the Year Selection Committee. Because of our personal connection, we know of all the good that they do. We feel it is time the rest of our community recognize what we know to be fact. The main ingredient of their characters is unselfish dedication to the community and its citizens.
Signed.
Oh. That's from the staff at Caldwell Agencies.
Yeah.
Well, I made one mistake.
Well, I just gotta tell you, Alan, the staff has to say something nice. If they don't say anything nice, they're fired. When I worked there, I got fired on a regular basis, once a week, fired.
I remember that.
This next letter is from Dr. Oliver Westrup. As a businessman, Bud is well respected for his assistance to his many clients. No one has ever been turned away for monetary reasons.
The Real Estate Council of British Columbia. I have known the Caldwells for over 20 years and have been impressed by their dedication to and enthusiastic support of worthy causes. Bud and Maxine served the council exceedingly well and brought credit and respect to themselves and their community.
You know, when I told you before that Maxine was the first woman elected to council, I neglected to say that as at this date, she is the only woman that has served on the Real Estate Council of BC. Now, Maxine, I've been wondering if that is due to those tacky gifts that you bought at the Ultra Love Shop in Vancouver and presented to the councillors as your retirement presents.
Everybody had to take it.
They were terrible. The next letter is from Peter Norman, president, K40 Club. Throughout the years, Bud and Maxine have contributed their time, energy, and resources to the organization. Maxine has participated fully in this mixed club, at one time being president herself, the first K40 lady president in Canada.
My baby never went back.
He wrote the letter.
I understand they've changed the bylaws now to make sure it doesn't happen again anyway. So. Ed Murray, President, Rotary Club of Cranbrook. Bud is truly representative of one of Rotary's main mottos, service above self. Bud and Maxine have been good for Cranbrook in their never-ending support of community events, and Cranbrook certainly looks good on them.
This is from Mr. Peter Lehman, past alderman, City of Cranbrook. I believe that she portrays that very vital community spirit that is so essential to a good city. She does this with a very positive attitude and an enthusiastic personality. She projects this every year at our festival and did it so well when she organized the civic luncheon at her summer games. It's an honor to support her.
I've had to support her a few times myself. Joyce Metcalf.
And have always been impressed with the fun-loving qualities that she has. Any event is made better by Maxine having a scheme, plot, or plan, which is sure to put a little more fun into the event.
A little more fun. Any more fun and I'd be dead. Do you remember the time Maxine invented glass tabletop dancing? Howard Luxton, Secretary of the Lions Club. The Cranbrook Lions Club annual walkathon has always received the active support of Bud and Maxine. This long-standing support to this project has also encouraged others to get involved. The Lions Club extend their thank you to Bud and Maxine for their continuing support that has assisted the club in meeting its commitments.
Yeah, well, I'd just like to tell you how they get everybody involved. When you work for Bud and Maxine, they tell you, if you are not at the starting gate at 8 a.m. in the morning, you might as well just start working on your job resumes.
True.
Next letter from Mr. Ron Tarr, President, 1986 Summer Games. There is no doubt that with her rolled-up sleeves approach to the work, mixed with the right amount of levity, and with was the inspiration that guided her fellow committee people and assured this event was one to remember.
One to remember. I remember.
Never mind, Alan. We're not talking about that tonight.
We have a letter from Alex Demchuk, past president of the Legion. At the time of construction of the present Legion, Bud was first vice president and chairman of finance. He worked long and hard, and it was through this commitment he was able to keep the cost to the budgeted amount. His interest didn't stop there, as to this day, he is concerned about the well-being of veterans and has helped many of them when help was needed. We also have a similar letter from the current president, Colin Anderson.
Well, at least now I know why Bud's always the last person to leave the Legion at night. He's worried about the darn building. This letter is from Professor Stan Hamilton, Associate Dean, University of BC. Dear Bud and Max, just when I thought the city of Cranbrook had developed a mature, stately image, they do this. Bud and Maxine, as citizens of the year. This could set the Kootenai area back 50 years. The Kootenai Real Estate Board and the Real Estate Council are still recovering from your terms in office. And now the entire community has this. That's the wrong letter, I'm sorry. He wrote that after they won. This is the one he wrote before. I do suspect that joint nominations are somewhat rare, but called for in this case. Bud and Maxine have contributed greatly in their own way. However, they have always shared their interests, their commitment to the community, and to their respective careers. Given that they have been so supportive of one another, I believe they would recognize that their combined efforts have clearly exceeded the sum of their individual efforts. Therefore, it seems fitting they should be jointly nominated.
Vicki Adams, the Sam Steele Society. The continuous support of the Caldwells to Sam Steele Days is outstanding, to say the least. No one is a more enthusiastic supporter or promoter. We sincerely believe that the Caldwell involvement in this community has been felt with such impact as to affect everyone they come in contact with. In our opinion, the contribution of the Caldwells has made Cranbrook a better place in which to live.
Well, Alan just missed a few points here. It's about Fort Caldwell, full stop. I just wondered if any of you have noticed that we never have Bud cooking at Fort Steele. I have to tell you, he's absolutely hopeless in the kitchen. I got an emergency phone call one day to run up to the house to put the coffee on. Bud didn't know how to run the newfangled coffee pot they'd had for 10 years. The last one.
This final letter is my favorite, signed by five people. We are proud of them, not only as parents, but as involved citizens of Cranbrook. Although they have been committed to the community, they have an even deeper commitment to their family. Regardless of how busy they have been, as their children, we have never lacked for their time or love. Seeing their achievements from a family point of view, we feel that they are deserving of the title Citizens of the Year.
In closing, ladies and gentlemen, we would like to thank the Chamber of Commerce for the opportunity and the very great privilege to be able to speak tonight. Bud and Maxine, we congratulate you, and just thanks for everything. Thank you.
We have a whole mess of presentations now. It's going to be like a revolving door. I'd like to call Stan Graham, our Member of Parliament. Stan?
I'm going to split this into two, if you don't mind.
This picture?
No. You can't see the picture yet, Maxine.
Oh, okay.
But first of all, let me say that I did not have a letter of support there. And the reason was because you know very well, Maxine, I would love to have supported you in this. But there was another name attached, and you know, I something to do.
Besides, he only writes in Gaelic.
Maxine, on behalf of the federal government and this ever-loving member, I would like to present you with these two photographs. We better get them both the right way up. One is of the Prince Consort, and the other, of course, is of Her Majesty. They're primarily for your home. May I suggest that you can put them in any room in the house with the possible exception of the bathroom, because that way it'd be too close to the throne. And because, Bud, you're always spouting off about your rights, and everybody else's rates, it is with great pleasure that I present you with this, so that if you can find a spot on your office wall, and anybody who's been in this office knows very well there isn't a spot, but if you can find a spot, put it on the wall. If you can't, hang it on the door, will you? There is a spot.
Thank you, Stan.
Very nice of you.
I look forward to seeing the throne speech. Thank you, Stan. I'd now like to call Ann Edwards, our MLA. Ann?
We'll just stay right here handy. It looks like we're going to get a few more gifts.
That's great.
It's like Christmas.
The first people that we met when we came to Cranbrook were the Caldwells, and it was certainly a great pleasure. They had occurs. If we weren't, passing on another couple of members of the community into the school system, whom they welcomed, of course, or sorting dirty bottles for some school band, I was seeing Bud and Maxine Caldwell doing all the sort of community things that they do. And I'm not going to go into the number of things because it's just been reviewed, but they did some other things too that people are all keeping secret in their hearts. So what I want to say tonight, it's a great pleasure. I'm sorry I don't have a picture of the King and Queen of British Columbia to present. Their own, but I'm really delighted to be able to reach across a political chasm and represent the people that I represent and offer our greatest best wishes and thanks for the kinds of things that you've given to Cranbrook and the community spirit that's here.
Ann's husband, Mike, just a tremendous guy and a tremendous pilot, and we all know what happened to him very tragically, but the only name he ever called me was Harry Bud, and I really loved the guy, Ann. Thank you.
Mayor Rick Jenson.
Citizens of the Year, Mr. President, ladies and gentlemen. One of the neat things about being mayor is that I have had the opportunity to meet a lot of good people. Most of these people carry my respect, and some of the people carry my love. And Bud and Maxine, you carry both my respect and love. But, you know, who wouldn't love someone that wasn't afraid of a boa constrictor? Did you know that Maxine is fearless? We attended a municipal conference in Nelson when Maxine was on council. We stayed in a hotel that I don't care to remember the name of. The only way to lock the door was to prop a chair against it. And Alderman Caldwell's room didn't even have a chair. After the banquet, we were going to our rooms and we came across this big commotion. The lady entertainer in the bar had lost her boa constrictor, and they could not find it. Alderman Butler was quite taken back, but Alderman Caldwell was not fazed a bit. That night, I slept with one eye open, as I'm sure Evie did. In the morning, Maxine says she slept like a baby. Now, isn't that an impressive lady? I first met Bud 8 or 10 years ago, and Bud, I've learned a lot from you. If you've wondered about seeing me so much lately, it's because that I'm always trying to see you without a smile on your face. Cracked ribs are supposed to hurt, and when you're hurt, you're supposed to feel a little bit sorry for yourself. What does he do? He smiles. Is this guy human? Bud and Maxine have given so much to Cranbrook and expect nothing in return.
We were so pleased to see you both chosen as Citizens of the Year. You are Citizens of the Year in Cranbrook, but for 1 year. But you will be Bud and Maxine in our hearts forever. I would like to ask the council members in attendance to join me, please. You know, with a progressive city council, a chamber president that can do some creative bookkeeping, and a Citizen of the Year that's not afraid of boa constrictors, there is nothing that's going to stop us. Bud and Maxine, on behalf of the council members here tonight, and the citizens and our friends in this community, it's our pleasure to present you with this gift in celebration of you being chosen our Citizens of the Year.
The picture of the mayor.
There's only one thing I'd like to say about that trip to Nelson to the UBCM conference. When you go to something like that, of course, you're going to act and portray the image of your city to the best of your ability. And at the end of the conference that evening, we'd been asked to take part in a ceremony the next day, because Kimberly were vying to get the next conference in their city. And at that time in the morning, it was like at about 2 a.m. when the meeting broke up, I said, well, why don't we do something to help Kimberly get the conference in their city? And Rick said, good idea.
What do you mean when the meeting broke up and you ran out of booze?
So, anyhow, carrying right along, I said, well, what we should do is get a little bit of a band going or whatever. And, you know, to get a trumpet and a bugle and some cymbals at 3 a.m. is difficult. But I knew a couple of people in the real estate business over there and called them, and they said, yes, they'd be glad to provide the instruments we needed, and we'd be able to get them first thing in the morning. No, but we all went back to bed, and it was actually Evie's idea the next morning, because she said, well, I think we should go ahead with this. We've got to help our city. It's only 20 miles away. The business will be good for us, too. So let's go for it. And at this time, I thought, oh, gee, I don't know if this is such a good idea. So we did. We went out and got the instruments. And Rick was a little hesitant, and we did decide, and actually he can play the bugle quite well. So we went and got our instruments and went around the hall and really supported Kimberly, and they got the next UBCM conference. I think they just wanted to see what's going to happen in the Kootenays, so they got it back here.
City,
Ed Murray Rotary Club.
How you doing, guys?
Very well, thanks, Ed. Be nice.
First of all, I'd like to congratulate fellow Rotarian Brian Tully on his wonderful year as president of the Chamber of Commerce. 2 years. Sorry, Brian. Yep. And I'd also like to wish Gary Knight and Gloria all the best of luck in their coming year in 1988 as Chamber President. Tonight is a real highlight in a year that's been filled with many highlights for me as President of the Rotary Club. As a lot of you may know, Rotarians are the incredible hulks of Cranbrook. Our Mayor is a Rotarian. Our Member of Parliament, Stan Graham, is a Rotarian. The 1986 and 87 President of the Chamber of Commerce, Brian Tully, is a Rotarian. The Citizen of the Year in 1986, George Polis, is a Rotarian. And the 1987 Citizen of the Year is a Rotarian. Patty Page was the first female Rotarian in Cranbrook. This is Hulkmania. Tonight, we are here to honor Bud and Maxine Caldwell, and these people truly epitomize the spirit of Rotary in the city of Cranbrook. More than 25% of our club is here tonight to honor Bud and Maxine, and I think that speaks very well for all of our members. If you ever need your Christmas tree decorated after a Rotary Christmas party at 2 in the morning, call Maxine. She'll be there. On a golf trip this past summer, Bud and Maxine came along. There were about a dozen of us, and as we were getting ready to tee off, I said to Bud, Bud, I just got some new clubs for my wife. Bud's response was, geez, I wish I could make a trade like that. Cranbrook does look good on you, Bud and Maxine. And as you all join us in congratulating Bud on behalf of the Rotary Club of Cranbrook, Bud and Maxine, I'd like the members of our club and their spouses that are here to stand as we all congratulate Bud and Maxine.
Jenson, Kinsmen Club.
I just want to let you know, Ed, that us kinsmen make good Rotarians, don't we? Bud and Maxine, on behalf of the Kinsmen Club of Cranbrook, I'd like to congratulate you on your selection as Citizen of the Year. I tried to find out a little bit about Bud in the Kinsmen Club and had a difficult time. I was born in 1949, and I talked to this gentleman. He said, well, I think Bud started about 1949. I kind of gave up after that, but obviously Bud and Maxine have been serving this community since I was born, 1949. Congratulations.
To all whom are present, greetings. Let it be known and published throughout the realm in recognition of special services to our city and for a noble dedication in furthering the welfare of our city, Bud and Maxine Caldwell shall be saluted by the Sam Steele Society and be entitled to all due homage and special emoluments appertaining to their newly exalted position. Now therefore we do proclaim and decree they shall now and forthwith be known as Cranbrook's own compatible couple. Caretakers of countless causes, constantly caring with community commitment, chairing controversial committees, caught comically with costume crew in Cranbrook celebration, classy children cherish consistent compatibility, citizens concur with selection committee, Caldwells, we can't conceive a couple, we count on more. Clearly we say your consideration, compassion, and commitment create a better place in which to live. For this, the Sam Steele Society salutes you. Bud and Maxine will be supplied with complimentary passes to all functions of our festival and participate as prestigious persons in parade. We hereunto set our hands this 30th day of January, 1988. Congratulations, Bud and Maxine.
On behalf of Canadian Airlines International, I'd like to present to both of you not a one-way trip, but a return trip in our domestic world. And the reason why we keep it domestic is because of the Chamber of Commerce.
Now, Bud, we know you're a paratrooper. We don't want you jumping out of that plane, okay? I'd like to call George Poulos, last year's 1986 Citizen of the Year. George?
Good evening, everybody. New president, past president, new citizen of the year, ladies and gentlemen. For so many years, he select the man of the year in town. Nobody think to do something to put him in his head to look different for another all of us, because it's a different tonight. And I sit down in Apollo one day, I say, what I do with the bud? You're not supposed to be everybody the same. And I find, you know, my flowers up, I don't know if you see it. I say to him, can I make you one crown to put him in his new citizen of the year head? Say, go ahead. I did. You won't. Now, I got it here. I give it first to Maxine. Just lily flowers.
Thank you, George.
But no losing. I want for you, boss. Get up, please. Thank you, Bud. You take everything I got for 1 year. Take it over by yourself, but give it to the next one next year.
Oh, okay.
Congratulations. With that one, my manager for Apollo gave me this envelope. I don't know what you got inside.
Well, I hope it's a gift for spaghetti and meatballs.
I don't know. You have spaghetti, you have spaghetti. Congratulations, in
the
best.
Thank you, George.
Thanks ever so much, George.
Thank you.
Plumber's Brian Tully.
George, is it okay if I have a look at it?
I have a picture of the King and Queen of Cranbrook. The high point of being a president of the Chamber of Commerce is having the ability to walk into a room and ask somebody if they will accept the award as a citizen of the year, because it's not something you want to surprise them with. And I'd like to say that normally we give a small plaque just commemorating the occasion. However, this evening we had to get a large plaque because there's two of them. I'd like to call Bud and Maxine on behalf of the Chamber of Commerce a plaque for citizens of the year.
I'd now like to call the Not Ready for Prime Time Barbershop Group to the front. We have an octet plus one for a song prepared by Maxine and Bud's daughter Liz.
Bud and Maxine Caldwell, we are here to honor you. It's time that you were recognized for all. Maxine Caldwell, when you really want things done, she's always willing to help you out and makes the hard work fun. Protective in Shrine and Masons and K40 and Rotary, and he doesn't charge the seniors for his work as a notary. They carefully plan their business so well it makes you laugh. And they say they plan 5 children just in case they need more staff. For all this time and effort, effort and the work that you've done here. Cranbrook is pleased to have you both as citizens of the year.
Now everybody join in here. It's a sing-along.
I really appreciate everything that was said tonight and a lot of the things that weren't said, because a couple of mornings ago I was at a breakfast meeting at 7:30 and Tim Wood, the MC, who I knew at that time was the MC, said, "I think you should wear slacks on Saturday night, Mac." Oh no. And I'm really pleased that there wasn't anything worse said than I expected. So thank you very much, everyone, for the tributes that we've received this evening and the great gifts. But a special thank you to my family, because I know that the family Bud and I have are not just our kids, but our brothers and sisters and that. They were the ones that got the whole thing going, I think, and our close friends. And it is a special group of people here tonight. Thank you, everyone.
And I'd also like to reiterate what Maxine said. Recognize the K-40s over at this side of the hall. Peter Norman's on the outside of the table. And the Rotarians stood up, and right behind the camera down here are the Shriners. Thank you all for coming. As far as I'm concerned, there's a great lady here tonight, Joyce Metcalf, past Citizen of the Year. My old friend John Wheaton, whom most of you call Murray. His dad called him John, and that's the only name I ever heard him called by when I was a kid, so I called him John all my life. And of course, the Greek, Big George. And thanks a million for the crown, George. And as far as I'm concerned, there's one person in the hall tonight that I have the deepest respect for his courage to come back. He's sitting down there in a wheelchair, and his name is Ron Sims. He was involved, for those who don't know, in the air crash in the Cranbrook Airport a number of years ago, and he and his very charming wife, Sherry, are here tonight, and I'm very, very happy to see both of them. And as far as I'm concerned, there are not only two Citizens of the Year here tonight, there's 300. Thank you.
Contest. All you have to do is watch Shopping Channel 7, answer the famous couple question, and phone in your answer to 426-8900, Monday to Friday between 8:30 a.m. and 5 p.m. The questions change daily, and you are eligible to phone in one answer each day. Entrants must be 19 or over. The Forever Sweetheart Contest grand prize will be drawn live in the Cable Studio Friday, February 12th at 5 p.m. Be sure to tune in to Channel 11 for the draw. We would like to thank our many sponsors for their generous support. The Calabria Restaurant, offering fine Italian cuisine, will be providing a dinner for two. Sonia's China Cabinet, with three stores to serve you in Cranbrook, Trail, and Nelson, have a fine selection of china, crystal, and quality giftware. Sonia's will be giving each daily winner a china rose, and for the grand prize winners, a crystal heart-shaped serving dish. Cranbrook Lighting Limited, serving the community for many years, carries a variety of lighting fixtures and accessories to meet all your lighting needs. They also handle fine china and crystal. For the grand prize winning couple, Cranbrook Lighting has given two crystal champagne flutes. People's Drug Mart, with 12 employees to serve you, is pleased to be a participating sponsor for the Forever Sweetheart Contest. People's has provided chocolates for the three weekly winners, as well as men's and ladies' fragrances for the grand prize winners. And finally, thank you to Stefan's Hair Studio as a sponsor for the... Stefan's is providing special beauty care packages for each of the daily winners. Hair and beauty care is Stefan's business. The grand prize winners of the Forever Sweetheart Contest will be chauffeured to and from the restaurant on their special evening out. Thank you to Black & Lee Formal Wear for providing the driver's tuxedo.
So what are you doing tonight? Watching Super Channel? Or are you going to try and start the car and drag yourself to a movie when it's 20 below? When you get to a movie, find a seat. What have you got? Two basketball players in front, some guy doing a play-by-play three rows back. Who needs it? When you've got Super Channel, sit back in your favorite chair, put your feet up, try and do that in a theater. Make some popcorn and stay in your warm home and watch a movie on Super Channel. It's up to you. Television's brightest star, Super Channel.